In times of crisis, human beings get really creative. We saw this during World War II, when fears of an enemy attack moved President Roosevelt to turn to the automotive industry to build warplanes. On May 26, 1940, he announced that he was asking corporate manufacturers to help produce 50,000 combat aircraft in 12 months. At the time, that was more than all the planes built in the U.S. since the beginning of flight. The Ford Motor Company, in response to this commission, ended up building a plant called Willow Run, where it produced over 8,000 B-24 Liberators. Many women were employed there, including Rosie Will Monroe, the inspiration behind this famous poster. The plant was a marvel of manufacturing efficiency. Ford took what it did best, building machines very quickly, and applied that skill to something new, the airplane. 80 years later, at another plant down the road, a new team has joined a global effort of manufacturers like Tesla and GM and countless do-it-yourselfers working to respond to another desperate need, medical equipment. In March of 2020, the COVID pandemic pushed the demand for personal protective gear and ventilators to the brink. This is Adrian Price, the man leading Ford's effort to make face shields, gowns, respirators, and ventilators.
When you see some crisis like this, it was like, what can we do with automotive components that could actually help us deploy things into the field very quickly? And so that's where the idea of Apollo came from.
We gotta find a way to make this fit into the hole for this. Using nothing but that.
Our team was able to take a vented seat blower out of one of our vehicles and combine it with a filter and actually, you know, make something that was medically robust. And currently we're making face shields using EPDM rubber that actually comes from the door seals of some of our vehicles. So basically, as we think about building a new product, we think first about how do we build one, and then how do we build a few, and then how do we build them at rate?
So far, this effort has produced 20 million face shields and is on track to make 50,000 ventilators by mid-July. What makes all of this possible isn't just clever reimaginings of manufacturing processes. It's people.
I was an assembler. I was on the line for a Generation 4 battery for the electric cars. I just basically put some battery parts together. That was all I was doing.
I've made everything from 3.0 throttle bodies to throttle bodies for Mustangs. I've made alternators.
And then I got a call, and they asked me if I would be interested.
And I thought to myself, what would my dad do? He told me one time, he was like, Trina, there's two types of people in this world. There are people that do, and there are people that don't. He said, I am a person that does, and so are you. So April 17th, we went to work.
These workers were already collecting unemployment. They had no financial incentive to do this.
Yeah, I have a daughter that's a nurse, and I'm twice her age, and I thought, she's got her whole life to live. I'm going to do whatever I can to protect her and the other people that are putting their lives on the line.
My friend had gotten affected by it. I didn't know exactly if I would lose a friend or not. So it was just like, let me step out here and try to save some lives.
This is a very real thing. You know, I don't want anybody that I love or care about to die. I don't want anybody that you love or care about to die. I want them to get well. I want everybody to have a chance to be able to survive this.
There is no greater satisfaction than to help somebody. And when I tour at the work sites, it's amazing what they're doing. And they're doing it with a sense of pride.
And then the more I thought about it, I thought, wow, you know, my grandmother, she went to work in the factory when the war was breaking out. And I'm proud that she passed that legacy on. And I'm glad I stepped up to the plate and I'm gonna see it through.
I wish I wasn't doing this. I wish I was standing in battery screwing in my screws. That's what I wish I was doing, but I'm not. And until this venture is finished, I will be in the ventilator area, cutting all of my tubes to make sure that these things are distributed to the people that need them.
The equipment shortages caused by the global coronavirus pandemic have sparked a wave of innovation. People from across the world have applied their skills, and in some cases, just their determination, to try to solve this problem. How will these efforts be viewed by the lens of history? How will people 80 years from now remember this moment that we're now in? In a world that in many ways can feel so divided, it's times like these that unite us and put our ideals on full display, that show us that creativity, innovation, and empathy for others is something within each of us. It's what makes us human. Thanks for watching. For more videos on people working to move the world, subscribe to Freethink.